Hi, Father Ian Van Heusen here. So I want to share with y'all a story from a woman I was working with. And I asked her if I could share this story and she said it was okay. And what she kind of related to me, as I would call it, is when evangelization goes bad. So, you know, I don't want to disparage different faiths, different denominations. In a certain sense, being a part of a culture like America means that there's a free exchange of ideas. So you're free to try to convince me that your position is correct. And I should likewise be free to kind of convince you that my perspective is correct. I'm totally down for that. And I understand that sometimes involves layers of how we approach this question of evangelization. But she experienced a very aggressive and negative form that I think we could all learn from. So the first thing that happened was she was invited to a Bible study. By the way, we do the same thing. So a very informal setting with neighbors. And they said, you know, we're open to all denominations, which not necessarily a bad thing. Well, then she started to talk about some of her challenges. And one of the women in the Bible study said, you should talk with a minister. So they talked with a minister of another denomination. And at that meeting, the minister was incredibly negative and aggressive. And this was the dramatic part. The minister said, for her to be free from her problems, the particular problems she was dealing with, she had to renounce her Catholic faith. And was very aggressive about it. And, you know, it was like, yeah, that's not how to do things, right? And it's not just because she was told to renounce her Catholic faith. I mean, yeah, of course, I don't want people doing that. But that's not how we should go about evangelization. And a lot of times when people think of evangelization, they think of that kind of aggressive, manipulative tactics that some people use. Sometimes people, even within the Catholic Church, use those techniques. The difference, true evangelization, is about freedom. It's about honesty. Yeah, you know, we do Bible studies too, where we create those middle spaces, where we can talk about our ideas. But really, authentic faith, first of all, should lead to a harmony between faith and reason. There should be a growth in our reasonableness, our openness to others. And also, it should grow in freedom. There shouldn't be any compulsion with religion. You know, people will say, well, there's commandments, there's obligations. Those are freely accepted. You know, that's the environment in which faith flourishes, is where people are free to express their ideas and to have those honest disagreements without the concern of being emotionally manipulated. So I just want us to think about that. Maybe as an examination of conscience, you know, we can say, oh, it's those other people out there that are doing these bad. No. I'm always about starting with an examination of our own lives. You know, maybe we're doing that sometimes where we manipulate other people into agreeing with us. So what we want to do, examine ourselves. Are we using those manipulation techniques? And let us seek more and more to be okay with differences, to be okay with disagreements. Of course, we believe in truth. I want everybody to be Catholic, that's clear. But not because I've argued my way or that I've intimidated them into accepting the faith, but in that spirit of openness. That's what I'm about. Amen.